Shivaran, how are you? Now ready? Again we are here to learn something about our chapter Work, Energy, Power. In our last module, we have seen what is power, what is energy, what is the expression for kinetic energy, that is the half the product of mass and square of its velocity, that we have done. Now today, we are going to learn work energy theorem. Okay, so be ready. Now dear children, work energy theorem or work energy principle. Work energy principle. It is clear? Yes sir. Now, what is that work done by net force? Work done by net force in displacing a body. Work done by net force in displacing a body is equal to change in kinetic energy of the body is equal to change in kinetic energy of the body. Kinetic energy of the body. Okay? Yes. Thus, when a force does some work on a body, the kinetic energy of the body increases by the same amount. When you are doing your work, when you are applying a force and that does work, then kinetic energy of the body increases. What is that? Kinetic energy of the body increases by the same amount. Conversely, I can say when an opposing force, say retarding force, कोई बॉडी जा रही है हम खींच रहे हैं उसको. When a retarding force is applied on a body, its kinetic energy decreases. A retarding force applied on a body, then kinetic energy decreases. So this decrease in kinetic energy of the body is equal to the work done by the body against the retarding force. Is it clear? Yes sir. So thus, according to the work energy principle, work and kinetic energy are equivalent quantities. Work and kinetic energy both are equivalent quantities. Yes sir. Now, to prove this work energy theorem, now my problem is to prove work energy theorem. Here we are going to see, to prove work energy theorem, I confine ourselves to the motion in one dimension. I am talking about only the motion in one dimension. Okay, we are going only in a single direction. Suppose M be the mass of the body. M be the mass of the body. U is the initial velocity of the body. F is the force applied on the body. It is the force applied on a body. Along its direction of motion. जिधर motion हो रहा है body का उसी direction में force लग रहा है. That is the force applied. Now, A is the acceleration produced in the body. And V is the velocity of the body, your final velocity of the body after T second. It is the final velocity. four things we are having.
What is that, sir?
That is m is the mass of the body, u is the initial velocity of the body, f is the final velocity, f is the force applied, a is the acceleration, and v is the final velocity of the body after a time t second. The small amount of work done by the applied force on the body, small amount of work done by the applied force on the body is dW is equal to force into displacement in the direction of force. FTS we know very well, F is equal to M into A. I know very well acceleration is rate of change of velocity. A is equal to dv by dt. But dw comes out to be, put this value here, I am getting m dv by dt ds here. What is ds by dt? That is v. Here v is equal to ds by dt. That is dw is equal to mvdv. Write down. So dw comes out to be mvdv. So the total work done, by the applied force, total work done by the applied force on the body. Here, body in increasing the velocity from u to v, the velocity increases from u to v. So I can write integration of dw, integrating both the sides, this equation, that is mvdv. Integration of dw, w we know very well. Initial velocity is u, final velocity is v. M is a constant, may be taken out. Here it is v square by 2 with a limit u to v. So I can write m by 2 v square minus u square upon the limit. Then my dear children, I can write Increase in kinetic energy of the body. This is work energy theorem. It will definitely come in examination. State and prove work energy theorem. Is it clear? So write down now. The next thing we are going to start, that is potential energy. The next article we are going to learn, that is potential energy. Earlier we have seen kinetic energy. Earlier we have seen, here we are going to learn potential energy. PE. Earlier we have seen kinetic energy. The potential energy of a body is defined as the energy possessed by the body by virtue of its position or its configuration. Write down the definition. The potential energy of a body is defined as the energy. It is the energy possessed by the body. Energy possessed by the body by virtue of its position or configuration in some field, It is clear that this is the definition of potential energy. Now here we are going to derive the formula for the potential energy. First I am going to explain here. So potential energy is the energy that can be associated with the configuration or arrangement, we can say configuration or arrangement of a system of object that exert force on one another. They are exerting a force on one another. So its configuration of the system changes, when the configuration of the body or system changes, then we can say the potential energy of the body changes. Okay, now dear children, two important type of potential energy are, first gravitational potential energy, and the second one is elastic potential energy. First we are going to see gravitational potential energy, and second we have to see the elastic potential energy. Okay, for example I can say, when we wind the spring of our watch, जो हमारी वॉच होती है, when we wind the spring of our watch, suppose here is our watch, potential energy is stored in the spring. Potential energy in the spring on account of configuration of the turns of the spring. Okay, जितना turns होगे उतना ही हमारे पास potential energy generate होगी. As the spring unwinds, it works to move the hand of the watch, our hand watch. We are moving like this, that will convert potential energy. Then it is unwind, then watch will move. Thus the wound spring has a potential to do the work. Hence, write down the wound spring. And the wound spring has the potential. To do to do work. Similarly, when an any spring is compressed like this or stretched, when a spring is stretched or compressed, then what we observe? When the spring is compressed or stretched, work done in compressing, work done in compressing or stretching, the spring is stored in the spring in the form of potential energy. It is clear? So, my dear children, it is another example. So, I can say here, it is due to the potential energy of the compressed spring in a loaded pistol that the bullet is released with a large velocity on firing the pistol. On firing the pistol. That's why bullet gets a larger velocity. Okay? Yes, sir. These are the examples here. We can see now. Again, when a stress bow is released, when a stress bow, here is our bow, say something like this. When a stress bow is released, the arrow goes forward with a large velocity on account of potential energy of the stress bow. On a stress bow, that example we have seen in 9th class, remember it. This is also an example here. What do you mean by gravitational potential energy here? We saw here in a different example. Now, here we are going to see gravitational potential energy. Gravitational potential energy of a body, it is the energy possessed by the body. It is the energy possessed by the body. It is the energy possessed by the body. It is the energy possessed by the body is there by virtue of its position. By virtue of its position. By virtue of its position. Above the surface of the earth. Above the surface of the earth. Above the surface of the earth. Suppose we are taking this body from the earth, above the surface of the earth. Okay? Now, so the amount of work done in carrying the body from the surface of the earth, suppose here is the surface of the earth. You are taking the body in this manner. The amount of work done in carrying the body from the surface of the earth to its present position against the gravitational force of the earth. Hum body bilkul aa rahe hain, but the gravitational force in this direction. But the gravitational force in this direction. So we are taking the body from here to here against the gravitational force. Then what is going on? It is stored in the body in the form of gravitational potential energy. What is it called? Gravitational potential energy. When the body is allowed to fall, when the body is allowed to fall from a certain height, when the body is allowed to fall from a certain height, then what is going on? When the body is allowed to fall from that position, it can do the amount of work equal to the gravitational potential energy like this. This body is going down due to the gravitational potential energy. It is due to the gravitational potential energy. The gravitational potential energy of the water is stored. The gravitational potential energy of water is stored to a great height in dams. जो डैम्स होते हैं बहुत ऊंचाई पर होते हैं बच्चों, और वो पानी होता है ऊपर, और दैट वाटर कम्स डाउन फॉल्स ऑन अ टर्बाइन एंड वी कैन जनरेट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. वी कैन जनरेट electricity. So the use of that, the gravitational potential energy of a water, say real air water, is stored to a great height in dams, is used to run the turbines and produce kinetic energy or produce electrical energy at hydroelectric power station. By rotating a turbine, we can generate electricity. That is the use of gravitational potential energy of water. Okay, now I am going to calculate gravitational potential energy. Now, my dear children, I want to calculate gravitational potential energy. Let us see. To calculate gravitational potential energy, suppose m be the mass of the body. M be the mass of the body. G is the acceleration due to gravity. It is acceleration due to the gravity. X is the height through which the body is raised. That is the height through which the body is raised. Okay? Now, as the height through which the body is raised, if I assume that H is not too large, it is not too large, it is not too large, and the value of G is practically constant, say from here to here or here or here, the value of acceleration due to G is constant, then the force applied just to overcome the gravitational attraction is, that is, F is equal to mg. That is, F is equal to mg. Suppose here is the body taking from here to here. Say at height H. Here it is the force, mass of the body is m. G is the acceleration due to gravity. So I can write here, force applied at just to overcome gravitational attraction is, that is, F is equal to mg. F is equal to mg. Here. Okay? Yes, sir. Now, as the distance moved in the direction of the force applied at, so work done would be, the work done would be force into distance. Here it is the force mg and distance is h. So this is mgh. Not that we have taken the upward direction to be positive. When we are going the body from surface of the earth to a certain height, we are taking as a positive. What is that? We are taking as a positive here. So work done by the applied force is plus mgh. Work done by the applied force is plus mgh. Okay? Yes, sir. Now, however, work done by the gravitational force, work done by the gravitational force, that would be negative. Work done by the gravitational force would be minus mgh in opposite direction. This is the work done by the gravitational force, that is minus mgh. That is minus mgh. This work gets stored as a potential energy. This work gets stored as a potential energy. Okay? So write down here, the gravitational potential energy of a body as a function of H is denoted by V is at H. This is the gravitational potential energy at a certain height is represented by this symbol VH, and it is negative work done by the gravitational force in raising the body to the height H. okay, I can write here gravitational potential energy. Gravitational potential energy is V at a certain height is mgh. So it is a negative work done by the gravitational force in raising the body to a particular height, that is mgh. If h is taken as a variable, I can write differentiation of this dy dx of vh. इसका डिफरेंशिएशन कर लीजिए, दैट इज इक्वल टू माइनस ऑफ डी बाई डी एच ऑफ एम जी एच. तो आई कैन राइट हियर माइनस ऑफ एम जी, दैट इज एफ फोर्स. तो हियर यू कैन से एफ इज अ ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स ऑन द बॉडी. दिस एफ इज अ ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स ऑन द बॉडी. So, my dear children, F is the gravitational force on the body and the negative sign indicates that gravitational force is downward. Gravitational force is downward. The minus sign jo aa raha hai, it is due to the gravitational force that acts downwards. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So, gravitational force is downward. So thus gravitational force F equals the negative of the derivative of VH minus of d by dH of VH. Here this is the formula. Here it is the negative of the derivative of VH. So mathematically the potential energy VS is defined as force that can be written as F at any distance say x. That is equal to minus of dv by dx. It is a formula. Remember it. So I can say the potential energy Vx is defined as a force can be written as in this form. In this form. It is clear?
Yes, sir.
Now